school. It's the 8th day of February 2018. And as we like to say, whenever it's the 8th day of February, we like to think back to 1980, February 1980, when the Olympic torch arrived at Lake Placid. We have the honor of being there presenting a flag to the Olympic Organizing Committee, and we're there on a cold, frigid night in Lake Placid. And Dr. Robert Lopez brought in the Olympic torch into the stadium there at the ice skating oval, where Eric Heiden did all of his stuff. Well, that was back in 1980. We're all a lot younger, or not even here back then. That's what, 38 years ago? I'd say probably most of the people in this gym were not even around in 1980, but some of us were. It's the annual Section VII cheerleading competition, and also maybe the CVAC competition too. Exhibitions, Beaman Town Mod and Mariah JB's. I'm losing my voice, but fortunately I don't have to talk much tonight. In the co-ed division is NAC and Plattsburgh High School. In the Division II small varsity is Beaman Town, Northeastern, and Saranac. In the Division II large varsity is Peru. So Peru will represent section. The co-ed, either NAC or PHS will represent the section. And the small varsity is up for grabs. Beaman Town, the defending champion, Northeastern Cougars, and the Saranac Central Chiefs.
It is right around 6:30, and it's scheduled to start at 6:30. The doors opened at 5:30, and we walked in the gym at 5:45. This whole place was
already packed with cheering fans. They arrive early and stand in line to try to get a seat. Only a few stragglers have to stand on their far side, and they get to see the back of the cheer, because all everything on this side is filled to capacity. And sound of session. For young Mr. Mosley providing the music. This was originally scheduled for yesterday, but on the 7th, it was a Wednesday, but we were snowed out. And fortunately, the gymnasium and the DJ were available, so they were able to reschedule until tonight. But I know Plattsburgh High School and Saranac High School both have boys games, and I'm wondering if one or maybe even both of those teams might be having their senior night. So that would be unfortunate if some of these cheerleaders have to miss their senior night to be here to compete. This is their one time to actually compete here up in Section 7. As I said, there will be three categories in Section 7 that they'll be satisfying tonight, but there'll also be a CVAC overall champion round 2. But the sectional winners are the ones that will move on and represent Section 7 in state competition. We want to thank Vicky Nephew for keeping us alert of everything happening with the cheerleading. She does a great job at making sure that everything is pulled off right. And of course, Greg Myers here at Beaman Town. A lot of work for him. He's the athletic director here at Beaman Town Central School. We're going beyond 6:30 here, so we'll be back when they're ready to start the show.
Section 7 Cheerleading Championships. The next team will be competing for the title of Section 7 Champs and the opportunity to represent our section in the Western State Championships in Syracuse on March 3rd. In three divisions, Division 2, Small Varsity, Division 2, Large Varsity, and Co-ed. In addition to that honor, the CVAC League Championships will be awarded to the CVAC team with the highest overall score. Following tonight's team's competition, we will be having an exhibition performances by the Beacon Sound Modified and Moana JV. Our athletes also have the chance at individual recognition tonight, in addition to a jump off and longest held extension contest. We will be announcing the first ever CVAC All-Star team. CVAC coaches nominated and voted for these athletes for this honor who represent the strongest skills from around the league. It is a great way to recognize the hard work and talent of the athletes involved in our sport. I'd ask you to please stand for the national anthem. The cheer is not spared, but they will be coming out in the order that they will be performing in. The teams will present a brief introduction cheer together with Section VII. These performances are not judged or scored as part of the competition. And at this time, we welcome the small voice we got away with the town leaders. If you want to see the other
Go!
have a category of what we do here, that's very homies.
Thank you.
the host team, the Eaton Town Eagles. And according to the program, their members include Olivia Boyette, Ashlyn Drouet, Anna Dupree, Evan Franklin, Haley Martin, Annabelle Potts, Melissa Potts, Reagan Rostad, Reese Sharon, Emma Snook, Taylor May Tenian, Nicaea Towell, Cortland Trumbull, Kinsley White, Bailey Whitney, and Adriana Zaffaro, Coach Samantha Clancy. Up next is Northeastern Clinton. The cheers include Sarah Albers, Brooke Aubrey, Gina Bogdalzeroff, Emily Blair, Justice Brassard, Heather Shatanoff, Samantha Disco, Ellie Saborio, Olivia Gagno, Alexa McCaldy, Tabitha Parent, Sarah Pupor, Madison Savage, Bailey Sheehan, Emily Stiles, Skylyn Thompson, Emily Visconti, and Miranda White. Coaches are Sarah Hunter, and assisted is Stephanie Gaudette Russell. Those are the Cougars. Judges are seated down below.
Welcome to the floor, the Eagles are MCCS and I'm going to give you the satellite chiefs. Thank you.
Clinton Central School Cougars.
Each team, the top of the race has an incomplete before we move on to the next one. So I think I'm going to get the record for the floor. The second half chief, and I'm going to see Mark Down on that.
Thank you.
we have to give a very warm welcome to VHS. Can you make a big deal on that?
Strong, Isaiah Thompson, and Katie Vassar. Coach is Michelle Ruber, and the mascot is Ella Hartman. The last varsity team to come on the floor will be the Indians, Alyssa Brissett, Shamara Butler, Riley Cassidy, Brianna Durgan, Samantha Durgan, Karina Gentry, Navia Hendricks, Ciara Ledoux, Kennedy Lehu, Rethelyn Liberty, Lindsay Malatnock, Haley Mooney, Caitlin Parrott, Anna Pelkey, Emily Sirlock, Ariel Snow, Madison Stewart, and Tayana Wright. Coaches Michelle Bisaw, assisted by Brittany Krause.
In the last fashion category, this is the board of Indians. If you can tell my father's name,
The varsity performances. I don't know if I can say performances. I know a couple years ago I got criticized for using the wrong word to describe what just happened. Anyway, I thought it was a performance. Up next will be the Bateman Town Modified and then the Mariah JVs in an exhibition, both of them in exhibition. Bateman Town Modified.
that was the Beekman Town Modifies. Suzanne Casava, Alexandra Cholak, Daisy Dino, Briar Grom, Ryan Jimenez, Alexis McNeely, Maylee Morgan, Glenn Owen, Riley Quinn, Savannah Rivers, Evelyn Roberts, Vera Saliba, Emmeline Seymour, Kiera Simpson, Taylor Slagenwitz, Brenna Staley, Emma Stevens, Kiana Thomas, and Elena Whitney. Crystal Benware is the coach. Next will be the Mariah JVs. They'll be the last ones on the floor. They include Sydney Bobby, Jillian Eichen, Emily Ganji, Sydney Glebus, Lily Huckrow, Maggie May, Megan May, Alita Menard, Trinity Novak, Mackenzie Sadowski, Anna Slattery, and Kendra Wilbur. Vicky Nephew is the coach, assisted by Lauren Mabanyan. Before the Beekmantown JV stepped on the floor, we had about 35 minutes of video that began at 6:30. Now 8:05, so in about 90 minutes, we got 35 minutes of video because these judges are the most deliberate judges. I'm not going to say slow, but I'll say deliberate judges that we've ever come across. And it's really stretching this night out, making it at least 45 minutes longer than we expected that it would be. A few exhibition things here, a little competition on the floor, then they'll announce the winners, so don't go away. Up next is the jump off. This is the opening round of the jump off. One winner out of each of these jumps will move on to the next stage. So there's five of them.
This is the competition, I'll say competitor number one, competitor number two. We shall say competitor number one, two, or three, or whatever. That should be good. Competitor number one.
Yo. Yo. That's yo. I know her. I can't pick because I'm biased.
The
I don't
what they call it. They hold somebody up in the air, or we can hold the girl the longest, wins it. And a secret ballot.
Moving on to the final round, the voting is number 1369.
Ready. I'm ready. for the music is by Sound Obsession.
Okay, this is a good session, Congress. Set. 6, 7, 8.
What does that mean? Alright, get up there. Whoop, one down already. Whoop. Whoop, Peru back there, I don't know. There's one. Look out. See at least one wobbling here. Maybe the whole two done. There's some wobblers up there. Three done. Four done. We got one wobbling. Here we go. Oh, down to We're done. They're done. We're going to have three left very shortly here, I think. Three standing. Very shortly, I think we're going to have two. Could be here for a while. Don't go under
the road.
I don't know how they really choose all-stars, but they want to have all-stars, so let them have all-stars. So we're going to choose some all-stars here.
Let us do it. Cheerleading. Cheerleading. Come on, I'm taking Cheerleading. NCCS, Justin Blackley. Team Wilson, Bethany Shue, Emily Stiles, Bill Adams, Randy White, Skylar Jackson, Skylar Jones.
Thank you.
cheerleaders, Section VIII. Madison Burger, PHS, Jeff Burger. Ryan Huckberry, Ryan, number 10 jumps. This is our CVAC team for 2018.
All right. Congratulations to all those All-Stars. All right. Remember, there are three categories. There is, co-ed, Division II small, and Division II large. So three categories. We know Peru will be the Division II large, because they're the only ones competing in that category. And this is when the tears start right here, because these girls practice all year for this one day. They go on road trips for competitions. I know some have gone to the Albany area, some have gone to Augsburg, some have gone to both. So they go around, but as far as in their own area, this is their only competition. There'll also be, in addition to the three sectional winners, there'll also be a CVAC winner chosen from within those three sectional winners.
Can each winner reach the winner and go on to the state competition? In Division II, we are varsity, Peru.
And in small varsity, it was Northeastern, Beekman Town, and Saranac. They usually do 3-2-1, so see if they'll do it that way this year. Well, Peru, this Section 7, Division 2 large school champions. And the judges have left the building.
Small varsity, winner, Northeastern Benton.
Winners retain the title. They retain their title. There will be one more between Northern Adirondack and Plattsburgh High School. And then from the three of those, one of them will be chosen a CVAC winner.
First place, Larry Adirondack.
And now for the CVAC. Out there. Every school should be proud of what they did on the floor tonight. They all did a nice job, unfortunately.
So that'll wrap it up. Hometown Cable's coverage of the Section 7 and the CVAC champions here at Beekmantown Central School. It's February 8th, 2018. You're watching viewer-supported local television, Hometown Cable. If you enjoyed this programming, we need to hear from you. We need viewer supporters so we can keep this programming coming. We're getting more new ones on a regular basis, but we doesn't mean that we don't need you to step up and start supporting our efforts. So congratulations to all the people involved in a very successful night here in Beekmantown. Thanks for watching.